A high degree of cooperation between Kazakhstan and Azerbaijan is observed. To date, the countries are implementing joint projects in agriculture, food and metallurgical industries. Nur-Sultan and Baku plan to enhance interaction in energy and transport. The transport of cargoes between ports of Baku, Aktau and Koruk has increased by 71% over 11 months of last year. According to information of the Baku port, the number of containers has reached 22,000. Experts highlighted that it was related to the launch of Kazakh special feeder on the Caspian Sea. The increase of the number of containers is a result of the work of the feeder. It's a special vessel for transporting cargoes. More than 6,300 containers have been transported over 6 months of operating. This is a great indicator. Infrastructure improvement also led to growth of the passenger flow. The transportation has increased by 48% from January to December. The trade value between the two states amounted to over $200 million last year. The Azerbaijani Ministry of Agriculture reported that import of Kazakh grain has increased by almost three times. The Council on the Agro-Industrial Complex will be created under the Senate of Kazakh Parliament. All interested parties will be able to join the Council, including people working in the agro-industrial complex, government and domestic executive bodies, as well as professionals in science and human resources. As a result, the Council will become a platform for professional discussion of agriculture development. This was stated by Chairperson of the Senate of Kazakhstan, Dariga Nazarbayeva, during the meeting with representatives of the industry. Members of Senate, as well as heads of research and educational centers and agricultural universities, took part in the discussion. Professors said that the most up-to-date topic of agricultural science in Kazakhstan is creation of a system of knowledge transfer and technology commercialization. In addition, the area of human resources, as well as preservation of the gene pool of plants and seed production, should be taken into consideration. The Science Village project can become one of the solutions. The Senate's chairperson supported the project's idea. The Council for Import Substitution Industrialization will be created in Kazakhstan. During the first meeting, topics on increasing the volumes of domestic products and expanding sales markets will be discussed. As part of the new platform, entrepreneurs and public authorities will be developing and implementing investment projects for import substitution industrialization. The National Chamber of Entrepreneurs of Kazakhstan has selected more than 360 promising teams in five sectors. Last year, we exported 156,000 head of cattle and 260,000 of goats and sheep. Almost 80% in both categories have been exported to Uzbekistan.
Нам важно, чтобы рос не сырьевой сектор, производственный сектор.
Kyrgyzstan increased export volumes of honey in 2019. The total volume amounted to 510 tons. Kyrgyzstan exports honey to the United Arab Emirates, Saudi Arabia, Russia, the United States and China. From 150 to 170 tons of Kyrgyz honey is exported to China every year. The US also plans to increase import volumes of the Kyrgyz honey by several times. American entrepreneurs purchased 50 tons of honey from Bee Gardens of Kyrgyzstan last year. We collect honey from all regions of the country. Each region is different with its own climate. Therefore, the honey is different as well. We supply only 20% of our products to the domestic market, exporting 80% abroad. The product is very popular thanks to its quality. China buys organic honey free of antibiotics. Any foreign substances should be absent in beehives. Beekeepers must have certificates and veterinary documents to prove the absence of diseases. The Ministry of Agriculture will conduct animal identification in 2021. Bees will be identified as well. In total, 2019 was very productive for our country in terms of export. We need to increase the number of phytosanitary laboratories to improve this area. I am glad that our products have joined the American markets for the first time. Our company has its own private laboratory. The quality of produced goods is very important for us, since it could affect the country's reputation. Currently, the entire production system is automatized. We don't even touch the products. Our goal is to meet international standards. To date, 29 Kyrgyz honey producers are listed in the single registry of the Eurasian Economic Union. Work in this area will be continued this year. Export-oriented enterprises will receive additional support on behalf of the President of Kyrgyzstan. Kyrgyzstan and Tajikistan have started a process of the exchange of territories. Two countries will have to agree on the exchange of equivalent land between Kyrgyzstan's Batken and Tajikistan's Sugd regions. The boundary delimitation is listed in one of the protocol points signed by deputy prime ministers of the two countries. According to the joint protocol, the topographic working groups were instructed to work on consensual options for exchange of the equal-sized land between the Batken region and the Isfara city on territories of the Samarkandek and Koktash settlements by March 1st of this year. The working groups will have to provide the agreed description of the location of the borderline on 114 kilometers long settlements by February 15th. The joint protocol includes 6 points. In addition to the equivalent exchange of territories and harmonization of bilateral borders, there will be the joint patrol of border guards on roads between the border settlements. Local executive bodies were recommended to conduct the awareness-raising work among the population on the necessity of delimitation and demarcation of the borders. New technologies will be applied. For example, the video surveillance will be equipped in territories where citizens of the two countries are densely populated. Traffic lights will be installed in order to regulate traffic on shared roads. We will continue to carry out the awareness-raising activities among the population to keep the good neighborly relations in border areas. The Kyrgyz-Tajik border is more than 970 kilometers long, only 60% of which have been delimited and demarcated. Within the last year, representatives of the two countries held several high-level meetings. Based on their results, 34 large-scale topographic maps have been made, and the possibility of exchanging several land territories has been agreed. The Hoca Ahmet Yassavi International Kazakh-Turkish University in Turkistan has been given the special status. The relevant decree has been signed by the President of Kazakhstan, Kasym-Jomart Tokayev. Now, the university will become independent in academic, administrative, and financial matters. The university prepares doctors of philosophy, select courses of educational programs, and issue diplomas of their own sample. Graduates of this year will be the first to receive these diplomas. Young people from more than 100 countries study at the university. Classes are available in 4 languages, specifically in Kazakh, Russian, English, and Turkish. Some of the professors are invited foreigners. The university has been the first to receive the international status in Kazakhstan. The goal of the university is development of global educational programs. The educational programs imply that anyone in the world can apply for our programs. A person can study in language that he or she speaks. We give an opportunity to study in English and Turkish. After graduation, an alumna can apply for a job everywhere. This university focuses on development of large advanced educational programs, to which we should attract more students from all over the Central Asian region. The National Museum of Kazakhstan plans to organize a number of events dedicated to the 175th anniversary of the great poet and tell about his life and work. Today, personal belongings of the poet are stored in the museum. One of them is a jar donated by Abai himself to the Semipalatinsk Museum. Manuscripts and other valuable exhibits will be presented to the public. In addition, the exhibition of Jidele Burele Historical, Cultural and Literary Memorial Museum Reserve is planned to be opened in the National Museum. Abai was a well-rounded person. His musical heritage and key heritage, as well as his contribution to science and education, are of importance. In this regard, the international conference is planned to be organized in order to gather scientists. All of this is part of the goals set by the National Museum of Kazakhstan. Eighteen previously unpublished works of Ilyas Zhansugirov will be issued. The unpublished works of the poet of Kazakh literature were found in Russian archives. Local researchers presented it to the public as a result of the scientific expedition. One of the works won the main award of the competition, dedicated to the legacy of Ilyas Zhansugirov. Young journalists and writers of Kazakhstan took part in the contest. Only 7 samples were selected out of 135. He lived 44 years only and left such a rich legacy. Previously unknown documents, facts and details about Ilyas Zhansugirov's life were found during the expedition in Moscow and St. Petersburg. Copies of the unpublished works were sent to Kazakhstan. They will be available in electronic format in this February. Then they will be printed. Ethnic design has become a worldwide trend in the fashion industry. During the meeting in the capital, the chairperson of the Designers Union of Eurasia told that Kazakh national designers have won international competitions, which shows that this area is trending now. Yermek Asılhanov said that the ethnic style is famous today, since it is a mixture of ornaments with modern style patterns.
Қазір біз бір программа бағдарламамен жұмыс істеп отырмыз.
First of all, the ethnic design has its own place in the fashion industry, which is developing. The ethnic style includes eco-design. The Kazakh design and handicraft products are made from environmentally friendly materials. Meanwhile, we are working on one project. What kind of food did our ancestors, Turkic and Saka people, eat? We see that they had wooden, bone and leather dishes. We were surprised. We are restoring them now. Our goal is not to showcase the Kazakh design, but to find out about Kazakh spiritual and creative values through the Kazakh design and present them to the world. Bright, original and mysterious Kazakh ornaments have been used to decorate jewelry, fabric and household items since ancient times. However, today only a small part of national patterns, each with its own special meaning and significance, has retained their authenticity.
Орнаменты, в принципе, состоят в основном из двух модулей.
Ornaments consist of 2 models. First one is a spiral, which is a symbol of pictogram and evolution. The second one is an equilateral cross, which represents the 4 sides of the world and the god of sky, Tengri. Graphics of Kazakh ornaments have been preserved for many thousands of years.
Равносторонний крест. В казахском орнаменте сохранилась графика еще с протяжением много тысяч лет.
Each pattern reflects the unique features of Kazakh history and culture of the time when they worshipped the god of sky, Tengri. Since ancient times, the ornaments were considered as amulets protecting from evil. Some of them symbolized the beginning and the end of life. Historian Yerlan Kuzhabayev said that today only few people are familiar with semantics of the national ornaments. Many designers are confused about these things. For example, for someone who is alive, they mistakenly use pictograms of the dead people that symbolize afterlife. There are ornaments that should not be used to decorate the upper portions of a garment. The ornaments of a headdress have a different use.
Орнаменты для головного убора, они совсем другие.
Yerlan Kuzhabayev's book gives an opportunity to get familiar with symbolism and significance of national ornaments. The author had been working on the book for 8 years. He dedicated his research on development of the culture of Kazakh ornaments.